Welcome again. Right now we're at Romans chapter 3. Can anyone be righteous? This is going to be an awesome video because we're going to be talking about a lot of great things here. This is one of the biggest points in evangelical Christianity today, is that nobody can be righteous. So in context, we just came from a portion of scripture where Paul was talking about the Jews versus the Gentiles. When Paul says we here, he's talking about the Jews. They are the Gentiles. Let's read it. What then? Are we, the Jews, better than they, the Gentiles? No, in no way. For we previously warned both Jews and Greeks that they are all under sin. As it is written, there is no one righteous, no, not one. There is no one who understands. There is no one who seeks after God. They have all turned away. They have together become unprofitable. There is no one who does good. No, not so much as one. Psalm 14, verses 1 to 3, 53, verses 1 to 3, in Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 20. This is the mistake that a lot of Christians make. They take one little portion, they cut out one little portion of the Bible, and they make it like a universal, absolute truth, okay? That it's universally, absolutely applied to absolutely everybody. Think about this for a second. Is it true that everybody does wickedness? That everybody does wickedness? That there's none righteous? Is that to be applied to every single person alive? Does that mean that every baby that's born in the nurseries right now crying out that they have all done wickedness? That they've all committed crimes? That they've all sinned against the Almighty God? Take this in the greater context, okay? The greater context is the whole Bible. The whole Bible. Did you know that in the whole Bible that God talks about righteous people? He calls people righteous over 200 times? If there is no such thing as righteous people, who's God talking about? Imaginary friends? What's God talking about here? He says, this one's righteous, that one's righteous, this group of people are righteous. He said this over 200 times. For example, God said that Noah is righteous in Genesis chapter 6. It says in Job chapter 1 verse 1 that Job was perfect, perfect and upright. And one of my favorites, Luke chapter 1 verse 6, talking about Zechariah and Elizabeth, the parents of John the Baptist, it says they were both, guess what? Righteous. They were both righteous, walking in all the commands of the Lord blamelessly. Paul said in Philippians that according to the law, he is blameless. The word blameless here in the Greek, amemtos, means free from fault or defect. That means that the Bible tells you that Zechariah, Elizabeth, and Paul, guess what, in the quote-unquote New Testament, free from fault or defect. So then is it possible that everybody everywhere at all times is sinners and none are righteous and nobody seeks God and nobody calls upon God and nobody cares? Like, is that really what it means? Is that really what it means? Is it possible to obey the law of God the way God wants you to obey him? Is it possible to be righteous in the sense of obeying the commands of God as God wants you to? Deuteronomy chapter 30, God makes it clear after he brought down all the commands in Moses. He said, now what I'm commanding you today is not too difficult for you. And you know what? Rightly so. God is not a ruthless, unreasonable tyrant that he were to, you know, give commands to people that he knows can't obey them. Of course not. God's not like that. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. He's a God who's a very merciful God. It says that throughout the scripture. A merciful God wouldn't demand that his people obey commands that he knows they can't obey. Is it possible to be righteous in the eyes of God by obeying all his commands? The Bible and just common sense tells you the answer is an emphatic yes. Jesus said, be perfect. Jesus commanded us to be perfect in Matthew chapter 5. Would he command us to do something that is impossible to do? I don't think so. Jesus is not like that. He's not a ruthless, unreasonable tyrant overshooting his expectations of his people. But the question is, what is perfect in the eyes of Jesus? What is perfect in the eyes of God? You see, men's definition of perfection and men's definition of sin, it most times is a whole lot different than God's definition. Is it possible to sin no more? You know, Jesus commanded people time and time again, go and sin no more. Why would he say that if that's impossible to do? Because we know for sure it is possible to do. All of these scriptures that says stuff like, there's none righteous, that everybody does evil. That's not talking about everybody everywhere at all times. That's talking about a specific group of people. If you read it in context, okay? Read it in context, it can't mean everybody. Because if it did, then God contradicts himself here. He calls people righteous over 200 times, and then he says there's nobody righteous. Doesn't make sense. Let's read on. Verse 13, their throat is an open tomb. With their words they have used deceit. In other words, they're all liars. Now, if that's true, in a universal, absolute sense, for all people at all times, that means that the person who wrote this, David, is also a liar. And if he's a liar, then it means it's all a bunch of nonsense. Is that what it really means? Is that what it really means? It couldn't be that God called people righteous 200 times, over 200 times, and then all of a sudden said, I'm just joking with you. Then nobody's righteous. No, you need to get to the bottom of this. You need to take this in context. He's talking about a specific group of people at a specific time. A good example of this is Genesis chapter 6, where God said that the whole world was wicked. Okay, you could stop there and not really look at the big picture. You can say, God said the whole world, absolutely, universally, everybody, everywhere is wicked. There's nobody righteous. But read on and you'll find out that Noah was righteous and his family was saved because of that. So, it's not true that everybody, everywhere. God is talking about a certain people at a certain time. Psalm 14 says that God looked down and saw that there was nobody who sought God. Nobody would seek God. They're all just unrighteous. Nobody that would seek God. Nobody calls upon the name of God at all. Is that true for everybody at all times? Deuteronomy chapter 6 says that the whole nation of Israel said that they will call upon the name of the Lord and do all his commandments. 1 Kings chapter 18, Elijah calls upon the name of the Lord. Psalm 116, David calls upon the name of the Lord. Joel 2 says that everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. If Psalm 14 is true, where it's like nobody's righteous, nobody calls upon the name of the Lord, and that means everybody, everywhere, at all times, without exception, then guess what? Nobody will be saved because nobody will call upon the name of the Lord. That's not true for everybody. That is talking about a specific group of people at a specific time. Let's continue. The poison of viper is under their lips. Their mouth is full of cursing and bitterness. Again, is that talking about everybody all the time? Is that talking about the little babies that just got born yesterday? The cursing of bitterness is under their lips? Really? Their feet are swift to shed blood. Well, boy, those babies, they come up with guns, I'm telling you. They're swift to shed blood. Again, just use your common sense. This is not talking about everybody at all times. Babies are not born with bows and arrows. Destruction and misery are in their ways. The way of peace they haven't known. There is no fear of God before their eyes. As always, seek God. And if you seek God with all your heart, you will find him. Call upon him and he will show you great and mighty things.